I am again. Today I wanted to try a three-ring pour, but I'm going to try to pour it in a spiral, like this. And I'm going to use all metallics, and a black and a white, and I have mixed the Artesa Burnt Sienna. So that are the only non-metallics. Oh, and I have a beige that is no brand. So I'm going to fill up the cup and then we're gonna pour. First, I will put a layer of white in my cup. Oh guys, and I really wanted to thank you because this week I have reached over the 10,000 views, members, followers on YouTube. And I'm really grateful that you are all so loyal and so sweet with your comments and all following me. So that's just really great. I'm really proud of that. Let me see. I have a copper metallic. That's from Xenos. That's just from a local store here. It's their home brand. And now I will put in some beige. And I have some sort of a copper metallic, but it's more like a red metallic, red copper. I'm going to use that too. Now a little bit of black again. Here I have a gold that's from acrylfarben. Bit of white again. Now I will use the Artesa Burnt Sienna. I really love Burnt Sienna. Also, when I mix it use it with blue, I think Burnt Sienna and blue are beautiful together. And I have a metallic green, that was just a craft paint, no brand, that I mixed. But I really like that color, so I will use that too. A little bit of black again. A little bit of the red copper. Bit of the beige. A little bit black again. I'm trying not to spill paint on my canvas. I already did a little bit. Well, that's just acrylic pouring. You always make a mess. A little bit of white again. And I spilled another drop. Just a minute. I will get it off my canvas. Let me see. A little bit of the green metallic again. Sienna. A little bit of the black. A little bit of have the white. A little bit of the copper metallic. A little bit of the beige. A little bit of the red copper metallic. And a little bit of the black. And some white. Okay. I will put this aside now. First I will pour my canvas in a layer of black, so the paint will flow a lot better. First let me put this paint aside. We don't want to throw it over. You see, this is where I spilled, but it doesn't matter because I will pour black over it anyway. Let me get my palette knife to divide it. You know what I noticed? That a lot of people who do acrylic pouring are so very creative in a lots of things that they do. Most of them have do love to cook or have plants or have a lot of pets. They're really people that are always busy with doing whatever and being very creative, making life more beautiful. I really like that. I hope, I noticed that a lot of you saw that I was doing block painting that I put on Facebook. I will make a video how to mix paint for block paintings, and then I will do one on camera for you. Okay, this is divided enough. Now I will just pick it up and make it flow a little bit so that it's more smooth. I know this seems like a lot of paint, but if you want your painting to look really, really beautiful, please don't how do you call that? Don't spare paint, because you'll see that you just need a little bit more paint to make your paintings really look pretty. You don't want your canvas showing through or have spots anywhere, and you want there to be a nice thick layer on the canvas, so it will really how do you call that, straighten out. The paint will flow all down, and then it really will look beautiful. I have to wash my hands. Okay, I will just get a torch to blow out most of the air bubbles, so I don't have to do that later, and they can, and the paint can nicely flow. without making holes. That is important because you don't want holes in your canvas. That's also the reason that I pre-mix my paint. This paint is already a couple of weeks old. I do that so most of the air is already out. Okay, now we're going to try if I can make a spiral. I think it will be hard. This is not so easy, guys. It's really hard to make nice circles. I think this is going to be another beautiful pour. Colors look really warm. Besides bright colors, I love bright colors. I also really love the warm colors. And of course I like sparkles. I'm just a raven. The older I get, the more I like all the glitter and glamour. So yeah, I really like the gold and the metallics. I have a little bit of a leftover, but that's okay. I will make coasters with that later. Okay, this looks very interesting. Now I will try and tilt it a little bit, but not too much. I think it looks really interesting. I like the spiral thing. Of course, at the end I will make sure that it's nice and round again. You can still see this. Yeah, I think this looks really beautiful. There's no air bubbles in it. It looks really, really smooth. I'm just going to wash up my hands and I'll be back for a close-up. Just showing you from up close what it looks like. You see there's a really very pretty pattern. Looks interesting. Show you from this angle also. Yes, it really does look very, very pretty. Really nice and warm, very natural.